All right, now we're going to look at some easier temperature conversions. If you've already looked at the Celsius to Fahrenheit, we're going to look at the Celsius and the Kelvin scale. The Kelvin temperature scale is what we usually refer to as the absolute temperature scale. This is because it was devised such that zero on the Kelvin scale is absolutely positively the coldest possible temperature. There are some quantum mechanical principles which may or may not allow us to actually get colder than that. We're working on the details, and people a whole lot smarter than me are working on it and understand more about it than I do. But for us, we're going to say that zero on the Kelvin temperature scale is absolutely positively the coldest possible temperature. It was devised looking at gases, which is later on in the semester. And as scientists studied gases way back in the 1800s, they were able to theorize what would be the coldest temperature a sample of gas could get to. And you're welcome to look ahead if you want to see more about that. That's in the chapter on gases. The Celsius temperature scale, again, you refer to it as degrees Celsius. That's your unit for the Celsius temperature scale. The Kelvin temperature scale, you do not use the degree symbol, and you don't even actually say it, although I will sometimes say degrees Kelvin if I'm trying to emphasize that we're looking at a degree unit. But we don't use the degree symbol, we don't say the word degree when we're talking about Kelvin as a unit on a temperature scale. If we look at where these overlap, zero on the Celsius temperature scale, I'm going to put it up here. Zero is where water freezes. On the Kelvin temperature scale, water freezes at 273.15 Kelvin. Depending on what sort of problem you're working, numerical problem, you may or may not need the 0.15. I'll go ahead and include it in this discussion. Water boils at 100 degrees Celsius. So up here we're at 100 degrees Celsius. That's where water boils. On the Kelvin temperature scale, that occurs at 373.15 Kelvin. You'll notice there are 100 degrees difference on both the Celsius temperature scale and the Kelvin temperature scale. So 100 Kelvin is equal to 100 degrees Celsius in terms of the temperature change. You'll notice their zeros aren't the same place. To get to the zeros, I have to go way down on the scale. And remember, we said that the absolute zero, the zero on the Kelvin temperature scale, is absolutely the coldest that matter can get. Theoretically, we're not there yet. I'm going to put a slash through the zero just so that it doesn't look like I'm writing okay. I'm writing zero Kelvin. On the Celsius temperature scale, this would correspond to negative 273.15 degrees Celsius. So we see a pattern here, and to convert between the two is actually very simple. If you want the temperature in Kelvin, you simply take the Celsius value and add 273.15. If you have the Celsius value, you need to convert it to Kelvin, you add 273.15. If you have the Kelvin value and you want to convert it to Celsius, you would subtract 273.15. One good thing to keep in mind to make sure that you don't accidentally go backwards with these subtractions or additions is that the Kelvin temperature scale will always be positive. It'll always be greater than zero. You won't ever calculate a negative Kelvin for anything that's real. But the Celsius temperature scale can be either positive or negative depending on where you are relative to the freezing point of water.